Ease. Afternoon, Rangers. Oh, please sit. Please sit down. Thank you. All right, hey, it's great to be here and welcome to this year's Ranger Challenge competition. I need to start out first by congratulating you, right? Over 500 cadets in 3rd Brigade competed for the opportunity to stand where you're standing right now. And now there's only 7 of you left, right? And that's a pretty big deal. I also want to congratulate you on the opportunity to do something special, right? To represent not only your university, your program, and the proud profession that we're a part of. I am privileged, I'm honored that I get to wear the same uniform as you and watch this competition. Okay, mine's a different pattern, a different color, but we're all on the same team, right? And that's what counts, right? So you've already accomplished an awful lot. Think back of all the time and energy and strength that you've committed, the injuries that you've had to overcome, the pain you've had to overcome to be here. So be proud of yourselves. I congratulate each and every one of you for being here. Okay, these 48 hours are gonna be a challenge, there's no doubt. And you've already had your first part of the competition done and over with. And now you have a full day tomorrow, and it doesn't end until you finish an obstacle course bright and early on Sunday morning. So I think there's probably two ways that we can approach this competition, right? Option one is that you compete and go for the victory at the absolute all expenses. The only thing you're focused on is winning for your team. And that would be a pretty cool option, because winning is a pretty big deal in our line of work, right? Option two would be you compete as a member of your team and you seek to overcome each and every obstacle that comes before you and accomplish the mission. I like option two, right? Because at the end of the day, our Army, within this context, doesn't need 14 champions. I mean, it's good to have 14 champions, right? A 9-person and a 5-person cadet team. But what the Army really needs are 70 super leaders that are gonna go out and lead our soldiers, our men and women, across battlefields all across the world. And that's what we need. Because that's gonna happen, ladies and gentlemen, once you commission and go on and serve in our Army. The likelihood of that happening is very high. So we're gonna crown two champions, and we're gonna be very proud of them. But each and every one of you needs to commit yourselves to get something for yourselves and get something for your teams so you can help make our Army stronger and better. Everyone with me on that?
Yes, sir.
All right, so I'm just gonna close with a stanza of a poem that General of the Army Douglas MacArthur wrote many years ago, and it really applies to what we're doing here today, and I'm sure some of you have heard it. But he says, upon the fields of friendly strife are sown the seeds that on other fields, on other days, shall bear the fruits of victory. And that's what we're doing here today, right? We're preparing ourselves as leaders, as soldiers, to lead young men and women in combat at some distant day in the future that surely will come. So I want you to fight hard for your team, but most importantly, fight for each other. Can we all do that?
Yes, sir.
All right, I can't wait to get this thing going. Brigade! Up, ten, shoot! Let's begin the competition. And fall out.